This is for Monday, 20 February, 2023. My name's Collins, and I've come to bother you again. Let's see if I can keep this short. The question is, am I a giraffe or not? I am pale and old and overweight and kind of scruffy looking, so obviously I am a giraffe. But some people might dispute that. Does my saying I'm a giraffe make me a giraffe? Is that good enough? Should that be good enough? The reason I bring this up is because I've been wondering lately whether people really are what they say they are, or is there some objective reality in what they are that might, you know, belie their claim. For example, there are people who think they're conservative, but it's not really clear what they're conserving. And there are people who identify as liberal who, well, it's not entirely clear what they're liberal with, you see. Meanwhile, there are lots of people who say they're Christian who almost never seem to exhibit what I would recognize as Christian values in their either behavior or beliefs. And other kinds of people who call themselves Christians who do adhere to those values. So the definition seems to be split. You've got some Christians who are unforgiving, xenophobic, and intolerant, and other Christians who are embracing and loving and generous. Two very different kinds of people exhibiting different virtues and using the same name. That's kind of confusing. How does this happen? I think sometimes the labels outlive their essences. Like when somebody uses an old mayonnaise jar to hold nuts and bolts. The words on the container do not accurately describe their content. Political parties have always been shape-changing, even to this day, and most of the time their names are kind of false. In some cases, like Democrat and Republican in the U.S., the original meanings of the words were kind of empty and arbitrary enough that the characters living under them could shift gradually across time without regard to the meaning of the label. In the old days, the Democrats were the party of racism and defense of slavery, whereas the Republicans were the radical proponents of human rights. Now, things change. By the time I was a kid, the Republicans had come to represent big business interests and conservative right-wing values, and more recently they've come to represent certifiable abject delusionalism, at least according to me. But sometimes the same word can mean different things to different people. Remember Pol Pot? Apparently, Pol Pot used to think he was a communist, even though he didn't know anything about communism, per se. He was really a murderous madman, but he thought he was a communist. And more lately, you've got people using the term communist to decry anything remotely resembling civil society. So, as you can see, these labels are kind of up in the air. Oh yeah, and now we have crowds of people debating whether woke is a good or bad thing without ever having come to a consensus about what that word actually means. There's no objective definition of it. It's just another one of those all-purpose pejoratives that you can throw around. A mutable term. Mutable. Yeah, that's what's going on. The meanings of words are shifting around us, and it's hard to keep track of what things really mean anymore. Well, maybe it was always that way. I don't know. I'm reminded of junior high school when kids who didn't like me used to call me faggot. This is a word that traditionally meant homosexual, which I obviously wasn't, but that didn't matter. It was just like the worst possible insult they could throw at somebody. A squishy word, a mutable word. So I'd have to conclude that people are not necessarily what they say they are, because the definitions of what they are too squishy. And this could mean that I'm not really a giraffe. That's it for this week. Until next time, I wish you and your pronouns a feine avondverder.